गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स. सो स्टूडेंट्स, विदाउट वेस्टिंग टाइम वी विल कंटिन्यू विद द प्रीवियस चैप्टर, दैट इज एसिड बेसिस एंड सॉल्ट. सो वी डिस्कस्ड अबाउट द नेचुरल इंडिकेटर्स एंड टुडे वी विल डिस्कस अबाउट सिंथेटिक इंडिकेटर्स. सिंथेटिक इंडिकेटर्स आर प्रिपेयर्ड इन द लेबोरेटरी लाइक मिथाइल ऑरेंज एंड फिनोफ्थलीन. सो मिथाइल ऑरेंज इन एसिडिक सोल्यूशन gives red color, but in basic solution it gives yellow color. In acidic solution phenolphthalein, that is colorless, but in basic solution it gives pink color. Phenolphthalein is generally of pink color only. Okay, now what are the olfactory indicators? There are some substances whose odor changes in acidic or basic medium. For example, onion in vinegar. Vinegar is an acid. It is a weak acid. So in vinegar, the onion, it becomes odorless. Understood? I hope all of you have understood this thing. Now we will study the chemical reactions of acids, bases and salts. Okay. Now first chemical reaction is action of acid and base on metal. Or how the acids and bases they react with the metals. Now students, please refer activity 2.3 given on page 19 and figure 2.1. I repeat, refer activity 2.3, figure 2.1 given on page 19. Or you can also refer the image in the slide or the video. Okay, now here this is the apparatus setup. Here you will see that the test tube that is fixed or attached with the clamp stand, and on the other side one vessel is kept, and in this soap solution is taken, and the opening of the test tube that is closed by a cork having. Okay, now we will study the reaction of acid on metals, how the acids they react with metals. So students, the acids they react with metals to give salt and hydrogen. Now you just see activity 2.3, which is given on page 19. Here one experiment is set up. The test tube is fixed with a clamp stand, and on the other side a glass vessel is kept which contains soap solution. You can even see the image in the document. Now here in the test tube, please take 5 ml of sulfuric acid, and in this sulfuric acid you add zinc granules, solid pieces of zinc. You will see that a gas is evolved. And when that gas is passed through soap solution, bubbles are formed. And on bringing a lighted candle near the bubble, it burns with a hydrogen gases. These are the gas bubbles, and the hydrogen gas burns with a pop sound. Now children, if I write equation, we have taken sulfuric acid. This is acid, sulfuric acid. In this we added zinc, metal is zinc. And salt, zinc sulfate is formed, and hydrogen gas is evolved. Now, since this is a gas, we generally show it with this arrow like this. Now, see whether it's balanced or no. Sulfate, sulfate. Zinc is one. Here also zinc is one. Sulfur is one. Sulfur is one. Oxygen is 4. Oxygen is 4. Hydrogen is 2. Hydrogen is 2. So, this is balanced. Now, here, again, you can take another acid. We have taken hydrochloric acid, and you add zinc. You will get salt zinc chloride plus hydrogen gas is evolved. So see, this is also acid. This is metal, salt and hydrogen gas is evolved. You can take other metal also, but that metal has to be above hydrogen in the reactivity series. The metals which are placed below hydrogen in the reactivity series, those metals, they do not liberate hydrogen. I hope all of you have understood. Now, this was the action of acid with metal. Now we will see the action of base with metal. Now you take base. Same in base also, base reacts with metals to give salt plus hydrogen. Okay, now you take base, sodium hydroxide. All the bases, they do not react with metals. Let us say metal, let us take metal zinc. You will get salt, which is called as sodium zincate. It is written as Na2ZnO2. And gas evolved is hydrogen. I hope this is clear to everyone. So here also, and if you will balance, you will get this one. Okay, this is the action of base with metals. Now, in both the cases, you will get salt and hydrogen. Now, we will study the action of metal carbonates and metal hydrogen carbonates with acids. How the acids, they react with metal carbonates and metal hydrogen carbonates. Now, please refer image 2 in the document. Here, you take two test tubes, test tube A and test tube B. In test tube A, you take acid, you take hydrochloric acid, and to it you add metal carbonate. And in test tube 2 also, you take hydrochloric acid and you add metal hydrogen carbonate. First of all, what is metal carbonate? What is metal? Sodium is a metal. Carbonate, CO3 is a carbonate. Now you have to write a formula. Sodium valency is 1, carbonate valency is 2. So this is sodium carbonate, or you can say metal carbonate. What is metal hydrogen carbonate? Sodium is metal. This is hydrogen. This is carbonate. Now, if you take this as 1, this is 1. This is hydrogen carbonate, which is also called as bicarbonate. And the valency of bicarbonate is -1 and sodium is +1. So they both cancel each other and we get this thing. So we also say sodium bicarbonate or sodium hydrogen carbonate. So now let us see the action of acid on metal carbonate and metal bicarbonate. Now what we have taken in one test tube A, we have taken sodium carbonate, and in another we have taken sodium bicarbonate. Now let us write the, we will see. First let us write the equation. We have taken sodium carbonate and we are adding which acid? HCl. Understood? Now you will see that when gas is liberated, and when that gas is passed through lime water turns milky. So it shows that the gas which is liberated is carbon dioxide, because carbon dioxide is the gas which turns lime water milky. And moreover, here this carbonate is present. So from carbonate, we will get carbon dioxide gas. I hope all of you have understood. We will get water and salt is form. This happens in test tube A. Now salt form is NaCl. I will write a balance equation. Okay. You will get water plus you will get carbon dioxide. I hope all of you have understood this thing. Hydrogen here it will be. So, which gas is liberated? Carbon dioxide gas is liberated in test tube 1. Now, let us take the case of metal hydrogen carbonate. NaHCO3. Here, if I will add HCl, you will get NaCl plus water plus carbon dioxide. Here also you will get the same thing. You will see in test tube 2 also, when gas is evolved, okay, and that gas turns lime water milky, that is carbon dioxide. So because in both the cases carbonate is present, so acids, they liberate carbon dioxide gas Water and salt is formed when acids and carbonates or metal carbonates, they react with each other. I hope it is understood to everyone. Okay, students, now we will study or we will learn about the reaction between acids and base. Now you take 2 ml of dilute sodium hydroxide solution in a test tube. Okay, sodium hydroxide is a base. You take it in a test tube. Okay, now you add phenolphthalein solution in it. Solution means you add 1 or 2 drops of phenolphthalein, which is a indicator. The color will change to pink because phenolphthalein in sodium hydroxide gives pink color. Now after that you add slowly you add hydrochloric acid. You will observe that the pink color, it will start fading. It will change to colorless. What does it mean? It means that on adding acid, the both sodium hydroxide and hydrochloric acid, they are cancelling each other's effect. They are nullifying each other's effect. And when the solution turns colorless, means now neither it is acidic, neither it is basic. They are neutralizing each other's effect. Now again, if you will add sodium hydroxide, the solution will turn pink, which shows that now it is becoming basic. So this is called as neutralization reaction. Neutralization reaction, here the acids, they react with base to form salt and water. Now here acid taken is hydrochloric acid, base taken is sodium hydroxide, and NaCl is salt and H2O is water. You can take other base also. Let us take KOH, potassium hydroxide, plus hydrochloric or H2SO4, sulfuric acid. So this is acid, base, you will get salt and water. That is K2SO4 is salt plus H2O. K2SO4 is potassium sulfate. Here the valency of sulfate is 2 and valency of potassium is 1. So you will get potassium sulfate. So this is neutralization reaction. Here the acids and the bases, they react with each other to form salt and water. You can see activity 2.6 given on page 21. Okay, students, rest we will study in next class. And after this, you will complete assignment. Whatever assignment is given to you, you will complete that one. And if you have any doubt, that also you will clarify. Thank you, students.